Xbox Game Boy, yeah. So today is quite something new. It's a new series. So a lot of times I'll be thinking as to how can I make the channel more interesting for you, the fans and viewers. You know, I'll keep on giving you some of the best music that I've been allowed to give you by the artists. But then it cannot only be about the songs. I gotta make it more, the channel more engaging, more fun, more entertaining for you. So as I was thinking, I realized that last year I started this series on my blog about the best albums from Zimbabwe. So I just realized, you know what, this thing, it'll be great if I make it a web series. So now, yeah, here we are. So before we start, the thing is, for every episode, I'll be mentioning about five albums. And for now, I'll be releasing one episode each month. So for those who like to know more about Zim music, more about the best local albums you can get, or maybe you're interested, you want to know what Zim has to offer in terms of music, I think this is the series for you. Keep tuned and enjoy yourself. So the best album is the 1998 classic, Ancient Voices, by the late Sister Chi. Now this is an amazing album. I'm a big, big fan of the album. I remember I was first introduced to the album through the movie Everyone Shout. This album was the major soundtrack for that movie. And if I ask a lot of, I think for a lot of singles out there, that's where you hear the song Tamari first. I know, Mudiwa Tamari, hey, my darling Tamari. I think for a lot of people, that's where they heard that song first. And after that, the album just won everyone else. And even the popularity of the album even was not just confined to the borders of Zimbabwe. The album was celebrated on a continental level, which saw the album being nominated. As Chuanis was nominated for the Best Female Artist at the Quarter All Music Awards the following year, which was in 1999. Also, the album was honored by Radio France that year. So this is an amazing album. And I think one of the things that just shows how good this album is that, you know what, for a lot of artists, most of you need maybe a career spanning 10 years or maybe 5 great albums to be named against the legends. But for Chuanizo, this album, just this one album, made her, it earned her a name among the local music legends. And it can just testify to, it will just show you that this is a beautiful, beautiful, very, very beautiful album. So the next album is Pyre by Oliver Mutukudze. Now this album was released in 2000. And Mutukudze has a very, very long catalog of albums. He has more than 60 albums. He has more than 400 tracks. But if you ask me, among all of those albums, Pyre is his best offering. This album is just amazing, and if you look at even at his career, before he released Pyre and after, you could clearly see the difference, and this album is the one that powered him into legendary status, is the one that made him a darling of many Zimbos. Right now, if you were to ask any random person, like, tell me any 5 Tugu songs, you know, there's definitely a high probability that they will tell you one or two tracks that come from this album, Pyre. And also, this album is when he took the baton stick from Chopper, because Chopper wrote the late 90s, and when Tuku released Pyre, everything changed from Chopper, and Tuku was the main man, Tuku was the biggest artist in Zimbabwe. So this album is really a masterpiece. Even if you look at the album, the tracks, and for some who attend a lot of his shows, you'll find out that most of the tracks from this album are some of the most requested during his live shows. And it just shows you, even more than 15 years later, this album still holds a special place in a lot of people's hearts, and is still loved by a lot of Zimbos. And it definitely deserves this spot among the best albums to ever come out of Zimbabwe. The next album is Choir Music, The African Page. Now this album took the whole nation by storm. Prior to the release of this album, African Page was not that much known. Maybe they were known in their hometown in Bulawayo, but outside Bulawayo, not much was known about them. And when they released this album, they became a household name. The leading track, Wanga, was the best track for the, I think it was the best song for that year. It was played everywhere. People could sing along to it. Old people, Twana, everyone could sing word to word of that track. The album is really solid. And after the release of that album, Africa Revenge attended a lot of shows. I think every big festival that came during that period, they had to put Africa Revenge. That's how good the album was. And also, up to today, about more than 10 years later, the album is still a benchmark in terms of jazz music. it set a standard which is very, very hard to beat. Even the guys from Africa themselves are failing to really beat that standard they set. So this is an amazing album. And for everyone who has been following Zim Music, you have definitely danced to Anga, or maybe Buwe Buwe, or my favorite from the album Memo, or Anochenget. Anochenget is known as a favorite of many. So this is a solid album. I love this album.
Feature it on the next episode. So yeah, that's it for today. See you again.